It is 7:44. It is an exciting time as we get ready to send our kids back to school, but it is also an important time to remember the hidden dangers that there are, from playground accidents to instances of bullying. We have attorney Charles Gilman with Gilman and Bedigian here to let us know the most common mishaps and who's at fault for this. I got to tell you, Charles, I've got a kindergartner going to school for the first time, and you start realizing there are some dangers to be aware of. There's 14 million kids in the U.S., Herb. What are the common injuries you see?
Often we see playground injuries, bullying incidents, and bus accidents are the three major accidents or places where injuries are happening in schools.
My goodness. Let's see if we can break this down and help some parents when it comes to playground injuries. Falling off the swings, maybe getting burned on a slide in the summertime if it's too hot. What happens from here? Are there legal ramifications?
There can be. Playground accidents are probably the hardest to discuss because playgrounds are inherently dangerous. The teachers have a duty to supervise the students on the playground within reason. You know, if the slide is too hot, like the example you used, they really should keep the kids inside or off the slides. But monkey bars are another great example. I mean, if you've got kindergartners climbing on monkey bars that are 5-6 feet off the ground, you know, look, hopefully there's enough wood chips or a soft enough surface that when they drop, they don't break anything, but it's going to happen.
Right.
It's just an inherently dangerous activity, climbing on monkey bars and going down slides.
It's scary for the kids, the parents of the kids, but also for the school, for liability. Is there anything protecting the schools in this?
Liability on the playgrounds is tough, but bullying and bus accidents is an entirely different story.
Right.
Because bus accidents, for example, somebody's negligent. Mm-hmm. Accidents don't generally happen but for negligence. So either you have the bus driver that was negligent or another driver, and those are much easier to talk about when you're talking about who has liability. In a situation with a bus accident, if another driver drove into the car, into the bus, the school's not liable.
Right.
But if the bus driver runs into a building or something awful like that, then yes, there's a good chance that the school system or the bus system or both are going to be liable.
We said that, you know, that was one of the possible injuries that can result, you know, from just the school year. How common is that?
Bus accidents?
Yeah.
Probably more common than any of us want to think about. And one of the issues is a lot of the buses still don't have seatbelts on them. So when you're talking about injuries on buses, it's like an MTA bus in Baltimore City or anywhere around. Sometimes the impact's not that severe, but it doesn't take much because the children aren't wearing seatbelts.
And we talk about another hidden danger, bullying, something surely many parents are aware of these days.
And that's one of the worst. Bullying comes in a couple different flavors, but the one flavor is the first time the bully does it, and then there's those kids that are constant bullies. And there is liability on the school system, as we're going to see this year most likely, or have seen. If the kid is a repeat bullier, then the school should have done something to remove that child or counsel that child or do something. Mm-hmm. If it's the first time the child's done that, it's going to be a little bit of a harder argument and much harder to hold the school liable for that action. Bullying is again, if you have a kid on the playground every day that's knocking somebody else's teeth out or giving out black eyes every day, the school's going to be liable for that because they should have known at that point.
It's important to know your rights, know the law. Thank you for coming in and shedding light on this. We appreciate it. And again, hopefully parents, you don't have to worry about those as we head into the new school year. 7:48, let's turn it over to meteorologist Jonathan Myers and see what's going on outside.